And for NASA, it's the same, obviously, demands. The president has called for NASA to step up in terms of technological innovation to address some of the societal challenges of understanding the climate better, monitoring Earth, human presence, and the whole issue of revolutionary breakthroughs. How do you see NASA trying to facilitate addressing that, making us more innovative?
One of our challenges in being a reliable international partner is that we go through periodic, like every 2 year and 4 year cycles. One of the things that I am excited about the budget that President Obama rolled out for us, the National Space Policy, is I think by calling on, by emphasizing the importance of international cooperation, in a way you sort of demand that there be some repetitiveness or some continuity to the way you do things. That is not historically the way the United States has done its space program. If you look at how we got to where we are today, I would say, you know, Jan mentioned this revolutionary development. Apollo Soyuz was revolutionary. It was at a time of war, the Cold War, but people felt that it was really important to do something different. And so we did Apollo Soyuz. The International Space Station, on the other hand, while it had a geopolitical reason to start, that was an evolutionary development that has brought in 15 or more international partners over time. And it is something that when it came time for us to evaluate what we were going to do in the future, the international partners came in and told the Augustine Committee, for example, you cannot get rid of the International Space Station. You know, our plan was to do away with it. But the international community said, we have time and money and everything invested in this, and we are finally about to see the point where we can now do legitimate science. You can't step away from that. So I think that, you know, that's why the president and I both like increased international involvement, because it demands that there be some consistency in the programs that you put in place.
And one of the things we'll get perhaps some questions here shortly, but you're making an interesting link between innovation and technology going in new ways, but also the collaboration, the partnering. And obviously with the International Space Station, it's been in a process of being built. Now we have a decade or more to, you know, to work and get science out of that. How is that serving as a model for how we partner together internationally and the benefits of that and moving forward?
I think there are a number of things with Station. It serves as a model for international collaboration and partnership because it is the result of treaties among nations. But then, as we started talking about initially, there is the matter of building trust, and that has come with time. That has been a very painful partnership in its development. When you talk about ESA, Roscosmos, the Japanese, us, the Canadians, you know, on and on and on, very diverse interests and very diverse capabilities. But Station has allowed nations of incredibly diverse capability to come together into one enterprise where, again, if I go back to this reciprocity, every partner is able to contribute something. It may not be the same monetary value, but in terms of contribution to the effort, everybody's on an equal footing. Yeah.
And if I may add something concerning the International Space Station. The International Space Station is, for us now, it's a perfect international forum for interaction. But it's also a perfect forum for actual science. And now you are using the word innovation. So we have now, within DLR, we looked into a little bit more into detail what is innovation. And we make a difference, maybe it's in English language not correct, but we are doing that, between an intervention and an innovation. So the scientific process starts with an idea and invents something and comes to knowledge, to maybe a product, even maybe a procedure or whatever. And then innovation is, to our understanding, something like a product for the market.